Azure is one of the most in-demand and used cloud platforms currently, and there's no better way to learn than to get hands-on. But to be able to use these services Azure has to offer, you'll need an account. We'll be signing up for a free Azure account today. The free account includes a trial that provides you with 12 months of access to popular Azure services and $200 USD in credits to spend in your first 30 days. Keep in mind that those amounts may change, so just double check before getting started. There are more than 25 Azure products that are always free thanks to their free tier, like Linux virtual machines, Azure SQL databases, Cosmos DB, and my personal favorite, Azure Functions. Even when your trial is done, there's still plenty to explore without having to spend. To create an account, you'll need a phone number, a credit card, a Microsoft or GitHub account. Credit card information during signup is used for identity verification only. So let's dive in.
Let's head over to azure.microsoft.com/free. This page contains some information on the Azure free account. Go ahead and give it a look before we get started. Once you're done with that, hit the green Start Free button. This page will take you to a Microsoft login. Fantastic, we're now going to sign in with our Microsoft account, or if you have a GitHub one, you can go ahead and use that. And it looks like I will need to use Authenticator to sign in. All right, we need to fill in the information in the Your Profile section. I'm going to go ahead and do that. Next, we have to verify our authentication by the phone number we've provided. So you'll need to provide a phone number and either request a call or a text. I'm going to hit text and fill in the verification code that's provided. Then I'm going to hit verify code. All right, next we have to verify our identity by card. And you can see here it says, we'll make a temporary authorization on this card, but you won't be charged unless you upgrade. So I'm gonna go ahead and fill in these details. All right, I'm gonna hit next. Okay, now we have to agree to the customer agreement and privacy statements by checking this box. You can take some time to review both of these documents. You've got links to go over both of them. And we're going to hit that checkbox on the side, and you can opt in to receive relevant information about Microsoft partner products and services if you'd like by hitting that checkbox. I'm going to click sign up here. And there we have it. When you sign up for an Azure account, an Azure subscription is also created by default. So now we've got our free Azure account, an Azure subscription, and $200 USD in credits for the next 30 days to explore.
Alrighty, Cloud Gurus, we've covered how to create a Microsoft Azure account. Keep in mind that even though a free account gives you credits, you could quickly consume those and get charged for consumed services. In order to avoid this, you'll want to set up budgets and cost alerts. Additionally, there are some security best practices that aren't implemented by default. For example, creating a less privileged user to work with. I highly recommend you look into these before you start playing around with your Azure services. And don't worry, I've added some additional resources in the show notes of this episode. That's it for this episode of ACG Fundamentals. Go on and create your free account. Give us a thumbs up once you do. Don't forget to subscribe for more cloud content. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus. See you in the next one.